In studio, we have Professor Gitile Naitule, Commissioner with the National Cohesion and Integration Commission. Professor, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thank you.
Now, the Kenyan Constitution stipulates that a Kenyan, any Kenyan, should work anywhere in this country. Mm. Is this hounding a potential vice chancellor of a public university on tribal grounds? What is your take?
That's what it is. It's actually hounding a qualified Kenyan, denying him an opportunity to work and to live anywhere within the country, as in by law also established, on tribal grounds. Those people are nothing but tribal bigots. And the country must stand behind this particular person. The country must stand behind the law and say no to this kind of action.
When you say stand by this person, what do you mean as the NCIC?
What we mean as the NCIC is that if we are going to have a united republic called Kenya, then Kenyans must have an undisputed right to live and work anywhere within the Republic of Kenya. If that interfered with, then we have no country. So even if this country must send the entire Kenyan military establishment to protect this man, to work in Moi University, that's what we must do to safeguard and establish that principle. Otherwise, we have no country. We are done.
This is not the first time this is happening, Professor. A few months ago, some of the political leadership still from the county of Uasin Gishu wanted Professor Teresa Akenga removed as Vice Chancellor of the University of Eldoret. Why do we get to these kinds of situations?
You know, there is a lot of immaturity in this country. This is just an indication of the kind of leaders we are electing. The leaders who have not been able to locate their position within Kenya. And this did not start now. It really didn't start now. Of course, the leadership in Eldoret seems more intent on propagating tribalism than other leaders in the country. But there is something very unfortunate which started during the Moi era within the university system. Because the university system is supposed to be the cradle where the nationhood, where the nationalism for Kenya is created. But then during the Moi era, we moved into employing university leaders from the villages where these universities are located, and completely messing up the system of making our children understand that they are within Kenya. That is happening right now. If you go to all these universities, you will find is the villagers ending them. Whether you go to Kabianga, whether you go to Meru University, whether you go to Chuka, whether you go to Kimathi, what you are finding is the villagers ending these institutions. This must stop because we need to build a united Kenya that the future generations can be proud of. And as a national cohesion, we will not encourage this because it's destroying our cohesiveness.
And
it's undermining our integration.
Right. This needs to be done, Professor. But where does the buck stop?
The buck stops with the appointing authority. We, as NCIC, would ask Matiang'i to put his foot down and to appoint Kenyans, qualified Kenyans, to run these institutions wherever they are, because these are national institutions.
Right. What is the leadership, is there a political will from what you have seen? Because this issue of ethnicization of public institutions, this includes institutions of higher learning, is not something that is new. Is there a political will?
I think there is a political will. I think a mistake was done in the past, and I think there is a process of correcting this mistake, because in 2008 we saw where this can take us. And I don't believe there's anyone in this country who would allow us to get back there. Because the moment we reject people based on the basis that they are not from our tribe, you know, the governor said we want somebody of our own. Who is our own? A Kenyan is our own. So once we allow that kind of language to enter into our system, then we're in the process of destroying this country, and I don't think anyone is prepared for that anymore.
Right. We can put the leaders, political leaders, on the spot over such utterances.
Yeah.
But as you say, this goes deep, even the student unions and all that, and the people who are supporting those political leaders in what they are saying.
Yes.
How do you as NCIC reach out to those people and preach to them what really your message is?
We have done that. Our chairman met all the vice chancellors in the universities. He requested them that they stop these tribe organizations within the universities, because we really don't need them. They are a threat to national cohesion and integration.
Right.
And most of them have agreed. Maseno University already is implementing that. Because also universities fund these organizations and they give them the patrons,
right,
so they can stop them. But I think more important is to realize that we have a nation to build, to make it out of these different countries that we now see propagating themselves, showing their end in Washington.
Right.
So once we realize that as a country, then we are moving in building that nation.
All right, let's just put into perspective some of the big universities across the countries, especially those ones that are outside the Kenyan capital, Nairobi. And the Masinde Muliro University of Science and Technology is headed by Professor Frederick Ochieng Otieno. He is the Vice Chancellor of the Masinde Muliro University of Science and Technology in Kakamega. In Chuka Town, Chuka University, the Vice Chancellor is Professor Erastus Njoka, who comes from that particular area. Pwani University, Vice Chancellor is Professor Mohamed S. Rajab. That is Pwani University, Pwani University in the county of Kilifi. Garissa University College, which is a constituent college of Moi University, is headed by Professor Ahmed Warfa, is the principal of the university college, constituent college of what we are talking about today, the Moi University. Kisii University is headed by Professor John Akama. Egerton University is headed by Professor Rose Awor Mwonya, is the Vice Chancellor. So, looking at that, Professor, you can see that it is a problem that is there. I mean, you can see some of those people from around that area.
I can tell you, just looking at this,
yes,
that it's okay for Masinde Muliro, because Professor Ochieng is, Masinde Muliro is in Kakamega,
yes,
and the professor is Alu. That's okay,
that's
for
fine,
us as a cohesion commission.
All right.
The so is Rose Mwonya. Rose Mwonya Tigaton is not in her village.
Yes, that's
so Rose Mwonya is right, also appropriate. But all the others would prefer that they are taken in some other universities within Kenya. Because what we want a child from Turkana.
Right.
Or a child from the farthest reaches of Kenya in Mandera.
All right.
When he enters Chuka University or whatever, or this university you are put here, they meet the management that reflects the face of Kenya.
Final question, Professor. Should the government, with the aid of you as the National Cohesion and Integration Commission, make a very deliberate move to move people who are from the area outside and make them go everywhere? Will that help cohesion in this
that
country?
That will help, and we think the government should do exactly that.
Right.
Because that will help cohesion. It will also help integrate, because we are assuming when you come from some other community to a new community, you understand that community better, and you are able now to balance our children that we bring to you, because these children come from all Kenya.
Right. Do you think you've done enough as a commission to help this?
We have. We have done an audit, which we have seen how skewed it is, because what is happening here, which you cannot see from the statement of the politician, is this villagization of the universities has created corruption networks, which are now being threatened by the measures now the new minister is taking.
All right.
Those corruption networks are the one being protected, because any new person will come and rough them. So all these networks have come as a result of collecting leaders, university leaders, and putting, we have done audit. We have seen how skewed the university management is in favor of the area where they are localized, the employment,
right,
and it has gone further than that. It's actually also gone to the village or the clans. Where the university is, you find that the clan where the vice chancellor come from is more employed within the university.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, Professor.
Thank you.
Professor Gitile Naitwile, a commissioner with the NCIC, the National Cohesion and Integration Commission. A political scientist, Professor Mutahi Ngunyi, now says that by last evening,